Hello students, today we are going to discuss the fourth unit of your textbook, which is titled as Films and Theatre. These are the terms which we use in our regular life related to our entertainment. Okay, so what is the point of entertainment? When we are tired, we just ask our parents to take us to the movie, right? So this is how we are going to discuss in this unit about certain important people who contributed their best in this field. Okay, so before entering into the topic, let us understand what is the definition of film. Film is a set or event or a story or event which is recorded by the cameras as a set of moving images. I repeat the definition. Film is a story or event which is recorded by the cameras as a set of moving images. Coming to the theater. Now, what is the difference between film and theater? As I said you, film is something which is recorded before the cameras, whereas theater is a stage where the live dramatic performances goes on. Okay, nowadays in this generation we are not able to find more theaters, okay, because they are not much encouraged, but we are still able to find films. Okay, as the technology is proceeding, there are more and more changes which are occurring in the development or the continuation of film industry. Let us enter into the first lesson under the main heading Film and Theatres. So the first lesson what we are going to discuss today is titled as Rendezvous with Ray. Okay, so what is the meaning? Let us try to understand the title first. Rendezvous. What is the meaning of rendezvous? This is the English term which literally means that to meet somebody, to meet some person at some agreed point of time. Like we may promise our friends, right, I'll be meeting you at 6 o'clock at this particular point, or I'll be coming to a coffee shop or somewhere like this. So this promising somebody to meet, this is called as rendezvous. So rendezvous with Ray. Let us see who was Ray and why this meeting point has come, and we'll understand why this title is chosen for the lesson at the end. So I hope the introduction part is clear with all of you. Now let us enter into the lesson. What is this lesson all about? This lesson is a kind of friendship between two people. Okay, now let us see who are those two personalities or two people about whom we are going to learn in this lesson. First one is Satyajit Ray. Okay, who was Satyajit Ray? He was one of the world's famous directors, and he was basically a Bengali. From Bengal he was. So coming to the second person, he was a French Canadian priest. I hope you all know who is priest. Okay, the one who heads in the church, generally called as father. Okay, so the other person is French Canadian priest whose name was Father Gaston Roberge. Okay, so this lesson is the friendship between Gaston Roberge and Satyajit Ray. So what has happened? How their friendship has started? Okay, before entering into all these things, let me tell you how actually a French person has come to know about the person of India. Okay, so what has happened? The Indian movies were shown or being played in the foreign countries also during the time of 20th century. So we had three set of movies which were titled as Apu Trilogy. Okay, these movies, three movies which were directed by Satyajit Ray. Satyajit Ray was the director. Okay, so that three set of movies was called as Apu Trilogy. What was Apu Trilogy? Now these three movies was having same characters, same people and same director. So there was no change in the characters. It was a continuous set of three movies. Okay, so this Apu Trilogy was watched by this Canadian priest who was called as Gaston Roberge. So Gaston Roberge, after seeing this Apu Trilogy, he was mesmerized by the director's ideas. Okay, so he wanted to meet this person. What was there in Apu Trilogy? What extent was shown that this person was so impressed by that? So in Apu Trilogy, what generally Satyajit Ray used to do is, he used to direct the movies on the theme called as poverty. Okay, poverty, I guess you all people understand. Poverty is nothing but it is a situation of the poor people. Okay, so how they are suffering in their regular life, daily life. So this was what was the concept taken by Satyajit Ray in his movies, and this was shown in Apu's Trilogy. Okay, so actually This before Apu's trilogy also, French-Canadian person knew about India, about Bengal. Through what? He knew through the poems of Rabindranath Tagore. He also knew through Reader's Digest article, which was about Mother Teresa. He also knew it through Marcia Iliad's La Nuit Bengali. Okay, so these were the three things through which he knew Bengal already. But more than these three things, he was more impressed by Apu's trilogy. There was an article titled as Saints of the Slum. Okay, so this article consisted of, you know, the terrific condition of the poor people in India. So after, you know, going through that article, Roberge was, you know, very much disturbed that so pathetic is the situation in India. Is this how he was so, you know, horrified by that. But after seeing this movie, which was Apu trilogy, he was assured that, okay, fine, though poverty is there in India, still the people in India are so humble, so prepared to manage it. So he was so impressed by that thing, okay. And he personally wanted to meet Satyajit Ray after coming to India. Are you getting my point? Till now what we have discussed, Satyajit Ray was one of the directors of India. He has, you know, directed so many movies. One of the movies was, I know, accidentally watched by Roberge, and then we have seen like how he was impressed by him. Now what happened in the next part? So generally, you know, when somebody does something good, there are people who tries to, you know, focus on positive things. There are also people who tries to focus on negative things. So in the same manner, when Satyajit Ray was, you know, directing movies, then there were critics who used to say that, you know, Satyajit Ray always focuses, India's poverty, and then he earns money through directing those kind of movies, and he then shows those movies to the Western countries. And Western countries, people, after watching the movie, they get very, you know, negative kind of idea about India. They feel India is a poor country. So this is how there were some critics who used to speak like this. But what was the opinion of Roberge? He said that please don't look into the negative side. See what actually is shown in the movie. Here, the director Satyajit Ray is not focusing on the, you know, poverty of India, but he is focusing on spiritual poverty of the people. Now, what is the meaning of spiritual poverty of the people? He is saying that, okay, there are poor people in India, we agree with that. But along with those, we also have certain rich people. Okay, but rich people are only rich in terms of money. They are not rich in terms of feelings. Okay, spiritually they are not behaving like, you know, human beings. So their spirit has gone low. Here the poverty is not shown in terms of money, but the poverty is shown in the terms of spirit. This was the idea of Roberge about Satyajit Ray's movies. Okay, then what has happened? Like, this person was so mesmerizing. In our life also we want to meet so many people. Okay, we have, you know, ambition of meeting, you know, great personalities. So we try our best to do that. In the same manner, even Roberge also tried a lot to meet Satyajit Ray. Then what he did? He came to India. Okay. After coming to India, he did not go and meet Satyajit Ray. Why he did not meet? Because he don't want to meet as a stranger. His goal was to have friendship with Satyajit Ray. So what to be done? See, if you want to become friend of somebody, you should know their likings, dislikings, their positives, negatives, right? So this is how Satyajit Ray, after coming to India, have spent 9 years, okay? 9 years he has spent, and then he got all the information about Satyajit Ray. Let me tell you, those 9 years, he joined in St. Xavier's College in Bengal, and he was staying there. And he took all the information about Satyajit Ray. After gathering all the information, he went to Satyajit Ray and he has given the hand of friendship to Satyajit Ray. And it was a very good friendship. It lasted for 22 years. Those two people. Who two people? Satyajit Ray and Roberge. Okay, Gaston Roberge. So these two people were very, very best friends. They have become very best friends. Every Sunday at 9 o'clock was their time to meet. Whatever is the situation, doesn't matter. If Ray is busy, doesn't matter. If Roberge is busy, doesn't matter. But both of them used to take out time for themselves at 9 o'clock on Sunday. Okay, so this is how their friendship, initially it was very, you know, like as usual one. but later on it deepened. Okay, like Ray used to call during his shooting times, he used to take suggestions from Roberge, like where to improve, what all new ideas to be added. This is how Roberge and Ray have become very, very good friends in their life. Okay, so let us see what Roberge want to tell about Ray's personality. Okay, generally Ray was very, you know, heighted, tall and stout person. Okay, so if some new stranger or some stranger sees him, they will feel, you know, like this person is very strict, okay, very reserved, okay, he doesn't talk much, not humorous. But what personally Roberge said, he was completely opposite to his personality. That person was very, very good, he was very calm, he was having a lot of sense of humor, he used to talk patiently to the people. Okay, this is how he complimented Ray's personality. And he said that Ray never accepted the compliments. He was feeling shy to accept the compliments. You know, this is the generosity. When we do something good, when somebody compliments us, we should feel happy, but we should not feel overconfident about ourselves. Okay, this is the good quality what we can learn from this lesson. Then what else has happened? There was one small incident which happened with Roberge and Ray. Okay, Ray used to have a habit of, you know, noting down all the scripts. I guess you all know what is a script, right? Before directing a movie, they write stories and all, okay? So in this manner, Ray used to maintain a set of scripts. Here and there, he used to draw some sketches, like how the dress of the, you know, character should be, how the set behind the screen should be. Everything he used to set and he used to maintain in his files or folders. At one point of time, Ray was sitting in a very disappointed mood, and at the same time Roberge went to him and saw that Ray was very much upset and then asked, what has happened, Ray? Then Ray said that short period of time ago there were some people who came to meet me, okay, and after they came, after the meeting, I have found that one file is missing from my set. And that file was the story of Charulata. Okay, so that file was the story of Charulata. And then, actually Ray knew who has taken that file, who has stolen that file. Then Roberge said, when you know who is the culprit, you should not keep quiet. You just go and ask, how did you dare to touch my file? How did you, take my file without my permission? This is what Roberge suggested to Ray. But what did Ray say, you know? Ray said that, no, I don't want to hurt the image of that person. Okay, he's such a great personality. If I say this kind of thing, if it is revealed to the people, his image would go down. I don't want to do that. I'm a human being, he is a human being. At some point of time, he may understand that he has done something wrong. So by seeing this, Roberge's respect has increased more and more and more for Ray. Okay, he said that really what sort of human being he was, so understandable. When he knew that somebody has done wrong, but still he did not want to point him. Okay, so this is how Roberge has been describing us about Ray's attitude, his personality and all. And one more thing what he said, you know, Ray was lovingly called by the people as Manikda. Okay, so Ray was called as Manikda by the people around him. So what Roberge compliments here is entire Bengal, okay, like, you know, the rich people, the poor people, the powerful people, the, you know, very harmonious people, the children, the elders, the men, the women, the all the characters, okay, all the nature people were seen in that person, particular person called Ray. So Ray was so ground to earth personality. He was, you know, complete Bengal can be seen in him. This is what was the opinion of Roberge. Then Roberge also added one more thing. He said that these words will not suffice Ray's personality. I will also add something else. It was said by Roberge. And what Roberge said? He said that great Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, he was a poet from Bengal. So he said that where Rabindranath Tagore has stopped this insight, from there Ray has picked it up. It indicates that Rabindranath Tagore, he has, you know, written one, okay, which was titled as Shabyatar Sankat. In English, it means crisis of civilization. Okay, so this is how this was written by Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, these were the philosophies. And the same philosophies, the same meaning was carried on to the next generation by or through Ray's movies. So Ray has directed the philosophies given by Rabindranath Tagore in Crisis of Civilization in his three movies called Ganashatru, Shakaprashat and Aganta. Okay, these were the three movies in which he has, you know, posed the feelings or the philosophies of Rabindranath Tagore through the movies. But this was not liked by most of the people, and they commented it in a negative manner, which was not liked by even Ray. Ray was so disappointed that when, you know, some self-realization is shown to the people, they don't want to see. When imagination is shown to the people, they are very much happy to see. Okay, this was what was the feeling of Ray. Okay, and after a few days, you know, as you people know, everything has an end. So here Ray's life also has come to an end. Ray was not feeling well for, you know, past many months together, and then finally he was bedridden. Bedridden, you understand, you know, continuously he was not well. And once, for the last time, when on Sunday, as I said, you, those friends had the habit of meeting at 9 o'clock, right? So, even like regular habit, Roberge has gone to meet Ray in the hospital. And Ray was lying on his deathbed. Means those were the last moments of Ray's life. So after seeing his, you know, bestie, his best friend Roberge, Manikda, okay, lovingly called Ray, he said that bhalo laglo, means it was very nice being with you, okay, all the while, all these years. And those were the last words which were spoken by Ray with his best friend. Okay, it was very painful moment for Roberge to leave his best friend, but, you know, nature is the thing which we have to accept, and Ray has lost his life. But what was the, you know, gift which was given by Roberge to Ray all the while in his life? It was one communication and film institute which was started by Roberge in 1970 in Bengal. Okay, so I hope you people understand what is film institute. It is a area where the films are shooted with many kinds of sets and all. So in Bengal, this film institute was started, which was named as Chitrabani. It was started by Roberge in 1970. And this Chitrabani Institute was given as a token of love to Ray, okay? And Ray became the co-founder of this institute. Even in this, after death of Ray, even this Roberge also directed so many movies, so many, you know, bioscripts and all these things. And then finally, you know, he also has shut it down, okay? So this is how we have seen about the friendship of Ray and Roberge Gaston, okay? So Ray was a world's, you know, greatest film director, whereas we have seen about the friendship of Ray and Gaston. Okay, so this was our story. So I hope now you understand why this title Rendezvous with Ray is taken, because a person who used to live in the west part of the world wanted to meet somebody in India, and that time they, you know, chosen. What was the time? It was sharp 9 o'clock on Sunday. They never missed it. All the while in 22 years. That was the reason this title was taken. I hope you all have understood the lesson. I hope even you people should have good friends in your life, and you should be loyal and faithful towards them till the end. Thank you, one. Thank you all.